the Politics Watch. This is LB. Now today I'm going to be talking about the very unfortunate story coming out of Westmoreland, a very small community known as Bullet Tree. Ironically, we're going to be talking about a stabbing. A man by the name of Garnet Foster lost his life. And based on the reports so far, the son is the main suspect. Yes, him own a son. Now, when I saw the name Garnet Foster, I thought, hold on, the name does look familiar. Because he actually made the headlines. You know, I'm always in the news, so I'm seeing names. I'm like, the name does look familiar. So I went back to some searches, and surely, it's the same Garnet Foster. The reason why he had made the news prior is because him and his wife, Camille, actually set up a school in them yard. Apparently they noticed that a lot of the children in the community, as you'd expect, Bullet Tree in Westmoreland, not exactly the wealthiest community in Jamaica, you know, a lot of people probably don't have it, a lot of children probably don't have it, and they didn't have any access to the Wi-Fi. Camille and Garnet Foster, seeing as how them have Wi-Fi, decided that they were going to, you know, invite a few kids over so that they can carry on them studies. A few kids turn into 5, 10 into 15. Next thing you know, at one point, right, the last I heard, it was as big as 25. Now, all of these children, right, they never have to pay feed. Camille and Garnet, right, shouldered the economic cost of all of this. The classroom was literally a chaparling. The only cover they had over their head was a chaparling outside of the house. And the couple did this, right, just for the youths them. As you can imagine, they're very, very popular. Garnet Foster was very popular. I think at one point, when the story came out, then you know it got ready. Some corporate companies decided they were going to give them a sponsorship to, you know, donate some things and, you know, towards the classrooms. So they picked them and up get them desk and, you know, look a book and all them things. Very unfortunate story. And I said the man has now lost his life and his son by the main suspect. And I say observer post a video and as the police man lead his son to the car, you can see the community is visibly upset. You see, how you know? Because right, when the name talk about, right, the acting will go down. Right. You see, when the cameraman stand up behind something and the body can't see him, right, that's when you record. That's when you see the most natural reactions. When you shine the camera in front of people, that's when you know you have your care scene, them run to the front and start getting rehearsed stories. But when the cameraman they be running their back, and I look up at that and I see people that hold them head, people that hold them side, yeah, people are ball. This man is very popular. Very popular. And he was a pastor, and you know, nowadays, come like every time you see pastor in the news, after the wrong reasons, yeah, it's nice to know that, you know, you still have your local community pastor that is beloved by the people. Yeah. Anyway, reports are that people them there, yeah, they hear a big commotion. Argument are going, father and son. No, that is not unusual. Obviously, yeah, I expect, well, you know the work to be said, tell us a boy, you know, and he make sure he say he don't get into no disagreements with the child because you want to make sure the child have everything their way, and you know, you should be the child's best friend. And if the child say they want to do something, just left them, that's what the work to be said, tell you. Right. So, it appears that Garnet was trying to discipline his son or say something to his son, and well, people start earballing. Obviously by this point he was now, right, being attacked. His mother, as in Garnet's mother, right, said she actually get wake up, right, by her grandson saying, right, his father is hurt. Now they had multiple children, the couple had multiple children, so it's probably the other son, right? One of his other son them will wake up granny and tell granny say, you know, mama, something. To daddy, she quickly put on her clothes, but by then it was too late. Right? All them could do was trim them on taxi. And from what I understand, the taxi was full of people, but them still put him on the back. The passengers them, I try to save him. People I try to put all kind of clothing and all kind of things on the wound them. Of course, you know, he got ready. The taxi man, I say, right, based on the injuries where him see, never look good. From the moment him see him, him know say never look good. And him rushing to the hospital, he didn't make it. Very, very unfortunate circumstance. So now, the father gone, and the son, right, is the main suspect. These are crazy times we're living in. Crazy, crazy times we're living in. And I said probably what make it even worse enough people is who it happened to. Because let's face it, sometimes some things reach some people in the community and the community are like, oh well, that's how you go. Yeah. I don't, sometimes they can tell by the attitude of the residents, they're like, well, good riddance. Yeah. Who cares? But in this instance, that doesn't seem to be the case. No, I don't know, right, obviously, what led to them getting in the altercation with son of a knife, and I don't know, but at this point, does it even matter? If you read about a story where the father gone a dove cut and the son I go possibly, right, again, assuming, right, cover with us, I go work it out, see, in the news. And the son do it, so son gone a horizon. Who wins this? Nobody no win. That family is destroyed. The family is destroyed because it lose the patriarch and one of the pit them. How do you get over that? The remaining siblings are now in a state where you miss your father, but you're also going to miss your brother. But are your brother, or you're not gonna see your father again? This is crazy times. Crazy times. And then on top of it, we have the video. Look Pitney, look girl. I don't know if the woman is her mother or what. One mug back and forth, one chew and lick the Pitney fling on back clean. The woman drip out Pitney drip back. I don't know, as I said. When I was growing up, this sort of thing was unheard of. Now, of course, Simon, I'm not saying it never happened nowhere in the entire Jamaica. I'm just telling you about what me know and what me see. I'm telling you, growing up, them things are unheard of. As bad as they want to be, you know, step to your father. As bad as they want to be. Hell, you wouldn't even step to your mother, because if she not leave with it, right? If she go say, alright, you disrespect me, you go tell your father, well, that's a whole different problem right there, so. That's a whole different problem right there, so. But no, I mean, I know. You know, if you go check the pipeline in Jamaica or something in the water, it's complete madness. Hard to wrap your head around these stories. And let me tell you this, anybody we can pick up a weapon against them parents, imagine what them will do to you. Anybody who can have a disagreement with them parents and resort to them kind of actions, imagine what them will do on a stranger. See, one time, parents used to have one talk with them, tell Pitney, say, me bring you into the world and me take you out back. Well, guess what? Now look like all the Pitney, them say, you bring me into the world, but me'll take you out. So just understand, say, the word respect in Jamaica, it look like it's an endangered species. If it was an animal, it would be an endangered species. And it's a powerful word, respect. Respect is what prevents you from saying certain things to certain people and doing certain things to certain people. That's why even to this day, enough time you'll be in a situation where, you know, a bigger man or a bigger woman, you know, a granny or a grandpa might do something nice or something. Where sometimes them wrong, you know, because old people can't wrong, you know. Not because you're old means say you can't wrong and you can't, you're infallible. No, old people can't wrong. But out of respect for granny or grandpa or for your elder. You just walk it out, you just let them alone. You know, alright, what you say? Alright, hold two thump. The reason why you don't do that, even though you can, because grandpa not going to win the fight against you. Grandma not going to win the fight against you. But you don't thump her down. That's respect, we stop that. So you see when certain things that, you know, intangible, we can't say like respect. You notice the intangibles are fading away from Jamaican society. Words like respect, loyalty, honor, those things are just fading away. Fade out like some clothes that we're washing. That, you know, left the clothes not too much in a bleach for too long, the color just fade out. And people don't rate the intangibles. People get modern Jamaica is too obsessed with them can't see. True people can't see respect, they can't see honor and them things that they don't value it. You can't put a price on it so people don't value it. Dangerous times. Dangerous times, let me say, very unfortunate story. Very unfortunate. You know, in the coming days, I go hear the juicy side of it. Yeah, him, they said this. And then, yes, yeah, him said this. That's how people need to look on the bigger picture, yes. And she said, when you start reading about things like this in the news, often, back to back, at them time, they only really need to start worrying about society. Because one thing, the clans and one other kill off each other. But when I start read about this and the things that start to become normal, well, you know, say serious times. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up himself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Ultra squad, stay circling. Bless.